Hello guys, welcome back to a new video. So today I'm going to start a new series on design patterns using Python 3. Apart from design patterns, we are going to use the latest features of Python 3 as well. So in this first video, we are going to discuss about factory design pattern. Okay. So let's first discuss what is factory design, why we need it, then we are going to implement in Python. So I've created a diagram for the same. So factory design pattern we use when we need the instance of the object on the go. So we don't need to create the object by ourselves and then passing the parameters or configuring it. So it will be done before in the class, and we are just going to give it the type, and we are going to get the object on the go in the runtime. So you can see like there is a factory. So we are going to have an example of a chair. Suppose you have a chair, you want the object of the chair on the go. You are just going to provide the type of the chair, and you will get the chair. So basically you can see the chair factory is here. There is a get chair method and it's a static method. I'm going to explain it in the code in a minute. So it has a parameter of chair type, which is a type of enum, so it can be big, small, anything we want to add in future as well. So it is extensible, and it is returning a chair. Okay, so we are just going to use chair factory dot get chair, and we will going to provide it the type of the chair, and we are going to get the chair. So now you can see I chair. So I represent the interface, and it's a chair interface. So as you know, so interface is strictly implemented by the class which is implementing the interface. So all the methods in the interface are going to strictly implement. So in Python we can't force it, but we can use the power of linters to strictly force it. So we are going to see that in code while I'm going to code. So for example, that iChair method, iChair interface has a method called get dimensions. So every inherited, or so it is the iChair interface is inherited or implemented by this chair abstract class, and every inherited class or the subclass of the chair, like the small chair and the big chair, going to forcefully implement this get dimension method. So that we have like same kind of methods in all the subclasses of chairs. And for example, for this use, for this tutorial, I am taking small chair and a big chair. You can also have like the extra large chair or a medium chair as well in future, so that it is extensible. Yeah, so and we have an enum class for chair type, which consists of the constant for like the type of chairs. Like currently we have big and small, we can extend it in future as well. So now it's all about the UML diagram. You can see the dotted and complete arrow that represents implementation, like the chair is going to implement the iChair interface, and the full line with a closed arrow represent the inheritance in UML. So you can see like small chair is inherited from the chair class. Similarly, the dotted line arrow with the open arrow is represent the dependency, like chair factory needs small chair and big chair and chair type. So chair factory is dependent on all these classes. So yeah, now this is about the chair class. Now let's see how it is implemented. So let's implement the factory method in Python. So you are not going to see the dialog box for like why I am going to create. I don't know, it's a problem in the OBS, so it's not it will not capture the dialog box in any ID. So yeah, sorry for that. So let me first create a directory called factory. Okay, so we are going to first create so I have the diagram here. So we are going to first create this interface. Okay, so if I'm going to write the code, it will take too much of time and the video will going to be long. So I'm just pasting already written code, which you can find link in the description, and I'm going to explain it like from top to bottom. Okay, so yeah, so let's first create a class, a file called i_chair. I represent the interface, so it's kind of a naming convention, i_chair. And then let me paste the code. So yeah, you can see so in Python we have to implement like interfaces are not built in Python. So there is a package called ABC, and it consists of ABC meta and abstract method method for like implementing a chair. So you can like write the name of the class, and then you can like type meta class equals to ABC meta, so it will make it as an interface. And since like interfaces have like abstract methods, so we have like in Python, so we have like written the get dimension method as like in our discussed in our like UML diagram, and I made it the abstract method using this annotation or decorator, whatever you call it. Okay, and this is like the doc strings always help in while like somebody is going to use this, and then it will automatically suggest this. Okay, so you can see here, I'm not sure you are going to see the suggestions because like OBS not capturing that. So now like we have to create the chair class. Okay, so this was the interface, which consists of one method get dimension, and the chair class will going to be abstract class. So as I told you, like in Python we create abstract class like in this way. So we import from ABC module, we import ABC, and then we will like write the name of the class, and then write the ABC means abstract base class, and it will convert this class into a abstract base class. And we are also, as discussed, we are going to implement this iChair for this all the chairs or the subclasses of this chair. Okay, so yeah, this is all about the chair class. So let's create small chair. So like I written a name, and then you can see the small chair, and then I'm in the parent class chair. Now you can see here there is a line, you can't see the suggestion, but it says class small, you can't see, but it says class small chair must implement all the abstract methods. So this under, you can see the squiggly line which forces us or just tells us like there is some methods you need to implement. So what you can do is just come here and then press Alt and then Enter. Then you will see a line to that reads as implement abstract method. When you click on that line, you will see like all the methods that are needed to implement, and then you can click on that dialog box, and then you will get this as the like automatically created by the ID. Now, since I like already written it, you can see this is the get dimension, and like I have, so in small chair, we are going to have like three fields, height, width, and they are like private fields. So in Python, we represent private as this underscore private methods or private variables as this underscore, and we are going to return, since we have to implement and return a dictionary, so we have like written all the height, width, and depth as a dictionary. Also, you can see this is called type annotation. So you can see so in Python there is no like forced way to write the return type or the variable type, but you can write like in this way so that the user will get suggestions that yeah, this function is going to return a dictionary type. So yeah, it's going to help if there is a large code base and people are like new, so that they can understand what is the return type. And yeah, so also there is a doc string that also like we will be representing the ID suggestions. Yeah, so also while creating some auto documentation, it is going to be added to that documentation as well. Yeah, so similarly we can create big chair. Yeah, so you can see the big chair, and it will inherit this chair, and we are it's kind of a similar to, but the data is changed, like 80 and 30. So it's for the sake of just a simple example, it's a simple class. Like we have now two classes, small and big chair. Okay, and now we have to create the actual factory class. So that is going to be chair factory. Yeah, so in this chair factory, I will like created the enum class as well. So in Python 3.9, so you can create enums using like enum classes. Like with this, you can import enum like enum from enum, and then you can write the inherit this enum, and you can just write the enums here, like small and big. You can assign it anything, like integer type or string type or any type. Yeah, so this is our chair type enum class, and this is like the chair factory, and it has one static method. So you can directly call this method without creating the instance of this class, just by like chair factory dot get chair. Okay, so those are called static methods, and like I've created get chair static method, and it's taking one chair type, so that it's going to return that kind of chair. So it is going to have like a big chair or a small chair. Yeah, you can see the return type as type annotated here, and it has the doc string, which like the have the param and the return type. Yeah, so if you can see, if the chair type equals to the like, if the given like the parameter of the chair type is like chair type dot big, we are going to create and return the big chair instance. And if it is a small, if the chair type is small, we are going to return the instance of small chair. Yeah, else we are for example, somebody just wrote chair dot medium, which don't exist, although we have like this kind of enforcement, like we have like only two in, but still somewhat right here, like the medium, and didn't implement it here. So we can like set the value like it is not implemented, or the implementation for this not found. Okay, yeah. Now let's use it and see in action how it going to how it is going to be used in a client file. Yeah, so yeah, this is pretty standard stuff. So basically we created a chair variable which is a type of chair, and you are using this chair factory, and as I told you, it is a static method. We don't need to create the instance, we just use the directly, and we are like telling it to give us the chair type big. So this chair function will going to print the dimension of the given type of chair. Okay, so let us see. For example, if this is a big chair, so it will going to give us the dictionary of this, and we are going to print that. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, you can see these are the dimension like 80 80 80 for big chair. As you can see, we have like written here, and for small it's 30 30 30. So we can in our client we can like change it to, so like it going to automatically suggest us two value, like the small and the big. Okay, so we can like write it small and then we can run it, so it will going to give us the small dimension on the go, as you can see. Yeah, so this is all about factory class or factory design pattern. In the next video we are going to see the builder pattern. Okay, so if you like the video, please hit like button and comment it down anything which you have like doubt, and also share with your friends or college mates, whatever, and please subscribe the channel so that you can get the video whenever it is put on the channel. Yeah, thanks.